Welcome back from that break. We are still here, Family Unscripted, and this is Urban TV. Thank you for joining us. Make sure you also join the conversation that is on Facebook and on Twitter. Look for Urban TV, look for Lynn Komzisha. You'll find the conversation there, and we'll try to understand each other. We're looking at why less and less men are committing and seem unready to, you know, commit to relationships and marriage. With me here is Semayengo Nicholas Ivan. He's a graphics designer. I have an artist and also a model in the names of Derek. I'm sorry, I can't pronounce the other name. Also, Charity. Charity is also a model. We're here trying to understand. Ivan, before we went for the break, you're saying there are reasons. What are those reasons?
We won't deny this. There are some little reasons when a man comes to you and he only wants to sleep with you.
I like what you
said. That's one reason. Secondly, he may be, he has someone else committed to when he's not committed to you. You get?
Yes.
So you'll be there around, just move around with him, have fun, parties, but elsewhere he's committed to someone. Mm. You get? So it's basically, those are the main reasons I may have. Or maybe some little quarrels. You know, these things do happen. But if someone is not committed, anything small, yes, just not anything small that may piss him off or annoy him will lead to you guys break up or stuff. And then you say you're not committed. But it's being committed to someone and loving someone. That's the basic point
You're
I'm sticking
emphasizing
on, yeah,
love, but most of us don't know what love is and we don't care anymore. I'm just speaking this on behalf of some people have told me, what is love? It's just fantasy. Why do you think today's young people don't really want to commit? They come to you and it's just fun. And the next thing you know is like, man, I'm not ready. Apart from the reasons you gave me, do you think things have changed at all?
Maybe. There are some things that have changed, maybe. You know, even these ladies are so demanding these days. You people are so demanding.
I was waiting for that one.
Mm-hmm. You're so demanding. You know, because if we say commit, because when I say unemployment, all guys are scared of getting committed because of unemployment and stuff. Because there are people out there that have nothing but are married. You get.
Okay.
So, I think it comes back to love. That's why I'm emphasizing that point. It's loving someone, caring about someone, love them, being happy in a relationship with someone. You get? Because it's not all about being, you should have money or stuff to
have
someone.
You can't survive without money.
I understand. But there are people out there surviving without money. You get? As long as they have something put in their mouth. You get? So I don't see it. I think it's maybe even not growing up, let me say, in the mind. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to sort of grow up. Some people think they're still young if they're grown up. And
yes. I like
secondly,
that.
And I also think this group appears and stuff. And so, you know, you may have a peer pressure. Friends are not into marriage, so you feel like you're also not ready yet. They have their own issues and problems, you get.
Mm.
So to me, it's, I think, growing up, knowing the right time, loving someone, and then things move on well.
That's Ivan for you. A bit complicated, but okay. Charity, do you really agree with Ivan at all? Why?
It's because Ivan says, like, one of the things he said was, we, the ladies, were so demanding.
Yes.
Mind you, we girls, nowadays we're not. We know what we want. The only thing we want from you is honesty and maybe show us that love. And though you have other people, make us the main girl. That's the only thing we want from you, not being demanding.
Saying it nicely. Be nice.
Be nice. Because the reason as to why most men nowadays don't want to be so committed is for the few friends I know, they always tell me, I just fear to break them. I don't want to be committed just because tomorrow I'll see some other girl and I want to go there. So I'm scared. I just don't want to break that girl. I can love her, but I just can't stay in there for long. Because I know myself.
Ivan is itching.
What I'm saying, that's what they say, being committed. You know, Because if he's scared of breaking your heart, it means he's not committed. You know, when you decide to love someone or to get married, you have to be committed and you're ready to love and care for that person. You get it? So you shouldn't worry about breaking her heart because you won't break her heart because you love her. You
get it? Okay.
So do you want to tell me those married people weren't committed when they got married and after they divorce?
There are issues. Of course, I can't deny that. But there are issues, you get. So, but what we're talking about here was getting committed to get into marriage, but not into marriage, because the issues that happen within the marriage.
Still, it's the same story. I
understand, but getting into marriage means you committed. Breaking up, there are maybe some certain reasons that I don't know yet, because I'm not yet into marriage. I'm just going into marriage.
But you have friends who are married.
Yeah, I have friends who are married, most of my friends, being honest, my friends haven't broken up in marriages.
Okay, but honest, you've had people breaking up.
I've had people, yeah, so their own reasons that I cannot tell and I can't know. You get.
You can't get married when you're not committed, that's for sure. Because you know marriage is a lifetime thing.
Mm.
Though one of these days people feel like it's a game, you go play on the ground and you just run away anytime you want to. But being committed, it's just knowing. It's obvious. Me, what I know personally, men will always have a side chick. But there is a way. If I'm your girl, make sure you treat me. There is a different
way. With respect.
Treat me differently. You go out there, treat them not like the way you treat me.
Wow.
And just don't let me know.
Men out there, you're in trouble. You're in a lot of trouble. If you have... She says all men have side. I don't know how true that is. But Derek here can tell us a little bit. Do you think what she says is true?
That all men are supposed, like, all
no,
men
not
have
supposed, side. They do.
They do. Nah, it's not true.
Mm-hmm.
It's not true. Yeah, there are some who have.
Of course, side. They can't. You won't accept. Okay, would you say there's a problem with the young generation? Okay, not very young, but currently, have systems changed? Have traditions changed? Do we view relationships in a different light?
Yeah.
Mm.
A lot has changed, I think.
Mm-hmm. What has changed?
There are media relationships and there are real relationships.
Media?
Yeah, media relationships. Like,
please explain that.
The Instagram relationships, those relationships that are all over place and they are trending. Really seems beautiful. Girls want that.
People who take photos and they're all over Instagram as a couple and blah,
yeah,
blah, blah.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So, most girls want something like that.
That is like that, flashy like that.
Yeah, flashy like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, with a lot of money into it. The cars, something like that, of which we cannot afford at this age.
So what happens when you can't afford it?
What happens when we can't afford them? The girls tend to go to the people that really can afford that.
And these people, what happens?
Most times the people who afford that
are
not into the girls.
You're making the point I was waiting for. So is the problem the girls or the men?
The problem is the girls, for God's sake. Men are okay.
How? I am with you. You're telling me you can't afford me. Wait, am I even a property in the first place?
No, you don't have to be a property to be afforded. I don't know. I didn't even use that word.
I'm just putting it in context because you say it is a flashy lifestyle.
Like commitment. Commitment is long-term. You have to be consistent and you have to be something. Yeah, so when someone realizes that you're not going to be what they want for a long term, there's no reason to commit to that.
You know why I'm quiet? Because this guy is just hitting it hard on the head. There's no one going to be committed to that. Well, We are here, and trust me, I want to. I'm tempted to go to social media because I posted these questions on social media, and the comments were over a million. Back to you, Charity. Like Derek has said, do you think women, we have a problem? Are we looking for something they don't have?
No.
Mm.
It's one thing they forget is we understand. We understand by the time we go to them.
Mm-hmm.
If we have to, we know what they're capable of and what they have. So the only thing they know, is they think, is because most of them have this mentality of girls always are looking for money, which is not true. So they always be so insecure. That's their insecurity.
Wow.
So they think because we want that money and they don't have any time anywhere we're going.
Oh, but they are the ones who want the money.
Yeah, they want the money. So they put it on us.
Exactly. Anyway, Ivan, do you agree?
Somehow I agree, but normally it's not about the money all sometimes. Because remember, I've told you, hours with my fiancé started way back in school.
And
really, in school, what did I have in school? Nothing. But it's just that we loved each other. We grew up with each other. So it came building slowly till we thought their time was right.
Mm.
Going back to him, I think when he said media, I think he meant like meeting someone or spouse on Facebook, Twitter, social media, stuff like that.
Mm.
So you with someone you related within social media is where you communicate, and then like you meet within a year and then you people get married and stuff, or you're not ready, you've met on social media. So I think that's media relationship, being with someone on social media, you meet them on social media, actually not in two person, but when you come to meet me like for a year and then you think you're ready, then go on and then things go bad.
And because you don't know each other.
You don't know each other.
I get you. All right, we'll take a quick break right now. When we return, we'll check what social media is saying. I can't wait because the comments. We'll be back.